and Corey.
Good morning.
Welcome to Kane and Corey. Listen live on the Audacy app.
My name is Kane. That's Corey.
Hell yeah!
There's Riley.
Morning.
That's producer Jay.
What's up?
How are you? You're the most important one. 55701, number to, not you, Jay, the listener. 55701, number to check in. I don't want to get any wrong ideas. Number to check in. B. Daniels and twins brothers Robin Mike checking in. You guys are first today.
Hell yeah, B. Daniels and brothers Robin.
He said, I love the intro to Friday's shows. It pumps me up. Well, there you go. That's the whole point. DB4 checking in after that horrible Steelers loss. Steelers loss, Vikings win.
Oh, really?
Although
you
know what?
Don't care about the Vikings?
No, I've never experienced a more embarrassing win in my life. The Vikings were up 29-0,
yeah, uh-huh.
And again, it came down to the final play of the game. The Steelers could have tied it, and the guy had a touchdown, but he dropped the ball. He dropped the ball, so the Vikings Vikinged is what they did. So, like, I'll take the win, but yeah. It
sounds like you're back on the horse, though.
Well, dude, you know what? That's what you say on Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday after you lose a game on Sunday. But then by Thursday, Friday, it starts to ramp up again, and you're a fan again. That's how it works.
Yeah,
it sucks.
That's toxic.
Mm. Yeah, it's like I'm saying. It's an abusive relationship that I keep going back to. I like being beaten. Sheila is here. What's up, Sheila? Joey O.
Joey O.
Little Leg Harbor. Oh, he has it. You did it, too. We'll get to that in a second, but I'll just tell you yours now. My new surgery date, December 29th. There you go.
Good job.
Yay.
All right.
Nice job,
Joey. We got
Joey.
Bassmaster Ryan and Davey D's up in this bitch.
SoFlo Guido checking in. Thanks for the show. Happy effing Friday.
Oh, Chaz from Tamarack, Florida.
Tommy two times from West Palm Beach. Vinny the Nine Lives Ninja.
Who's Dirty Little Sue from the Local 3?
I don't know, but I'd like to know.
Yeah, I want
to
find out.
Chaz from Tamarack, Florida.
Slick Nick from Detroit.
Matt in Ocala chewing in here.
Chewing?
That's what he says. He says he's chewing in here.
Okay.
Like maybe some chaw, some Copenhagen?
I guess.
Maybe he meant checking in?
Cat in a hat from Detroit. Propane Mike from Branchville.
Polly Bag of Donuts from the Local 3 in Brooklyn.
Road Warrior Rod. Checking in from Cedar Knoll. What?
Road Warrior Rod.
You gotta say it like that. Slick Nick checking in from Detroit.
Joey Bones. These are a bunch of...
I feel like we have a whole mafia.
I wish we had pictures of these people.
We did. It's the Kane and Corey Mafia.
Yeah, man.
That's cool.
I wish we had a picture of them on the wall. Like, we should have a wall full of the people that texting in with their picture and their nickname underneath it.
That's officially now... Yeah, that'd be great. But that's officially what we're calling the listeners. You're all, that's the mafia. It's our mafia.
Send us the picture you want to use at the Kane and Corey Instagram page.
That's your a good headshot. Idea, Corey. Send it ahead.
With your nickname. Why not?
No, it's great.
I'll make a wall of them.
Yeah. So explain again what you want.
I want a wall with their faces and their names underneath it.
Kind of creepy.
Like, what do you mean by wall?
I don't know. On the wall. We talk about put their pictures right here on the window.
Why don't we just post them on Instagram or something?
We could do that, too. But I also want a wall so we can look, say, the Nine Lives Ninja. And then I can look at it and be like,
man,
that's him.
I like all these walls. I don't want to put stuff on them.
How about the window right here?
I want to look out.
Well, hey, listen up, Hughes. I care more about you than the wall, unlike Kane does.
All right, what did you get accomplished this week? What you did at Texas 55701?
You did it. It's another week of reached the end. You conquered all those dragons. Go and tell your friends. It's Kane and Corey with your victories. You did it again. You did it.
Live from the Beverly Sunset Boutique at Disney's Hollywood Studios.
Lovely.
You can buy pins, food, gifts, and housewares.
Is there more to that commercial, is that it? All right. George from Instagram.
What'd you do?
Paid all my bills, and I actually have money left over.
You did it!
Yeah, George!
That's a good one.
That's possible? I didn't
SAU9. What'd you do? That's the wrong one. Scored high enough on a test making me eligible to be hired by the police department.
You did it!
Right. Congratulations.
That's amazing. Hey, Corey.
What'd you do?
Well, I had 7 hours of sleep last night.
You did it!
It was interrupted, but still, I laid there for 7 hours.
It's funny. You look more tired today than you have all week.
Yeah, I woke up at 10, then I woke up at 3, and then again at 4.
Oh, that's not good.
Your eyes are all glassy.
Yeah.
And bloodshot.
So what happens when you get kicked in the nose by a toddler?
You look like you've been... is that what happened?
Yeah.
You look like you've been smoking pot.
You have any?
Huh?
Yeah, huh?
No.
Okay.
I don't. Hey, me.
What'd you do?
I'm down 12 pounds this week.
You did it!
I know why, too. No sugar, and as you pointed out off the air, no booze.
No booze.
Corey. Yeah, no booze. Yeah.
And I think the key of it, though, is I told house guest Lisa to stop putting food in the house. There's nothing to eat in the house. Like, literally nothing, except for maybe some cold cuts or something. And so I'm too lazy to go get food, so I haven't been eating all week. And so there you go.
Wait, that's not healthy,
Well, that and the kidney failure, so it's
yeah,
all
Yeah, and the kidney failure, yeah. So it's probably more the kidney failure, but you know, hey.
It's a great weight loss technique, let me tell you.
I'm going to look good in the coffin.
Oh, jeez.
That's all I know. My mom used to yell at me when I would tan too much, and that's what I would say. Well, I'm going to die of skin cancer, but I'll look good in the coffin.
Oh, my God. No.
Wow. She didn't like when I said that.
I wonder why.
Let's see, 631.
What'd you do?
I got off my pain meds.
All right.
You did it!
954.
What'd you do?
Finally bought an engagement ring.
You did it!
Hey.
Wow.
954 again.
Oh, hell yeah!
Now, these buttons are too close. 954 again.
What'd you do?
Not mine, but my son Mason's getting out of the hospital today.
You did it!
That's kind of yours, too.
Yeah.
It's your son. Riley.
What'd you do?
I moved last week, and I know this is a small victory, but, like, I set up the Con Ed. I set up the Spectra. I set up all the, like, electricity, the bills.
So you did
set
adult
up.
Things,
you
finally.
Set it up.
Yeah. All you did, Corey's, all you did it was sleep,
call
okay?
Them. All you
yeah.
did was call
I
them.
I got everything. Yeah, exactly. I adulted, and I feel good about it. Thank
you
very much.
Dialed a number and said... I need to set this up.
Corey, like, yours, right. You did it was you fell asleep.
Hey, a lot harder than calling someone and tell them to come to my house and set something up.
No, they didn't even set it up. They send it to you. You have to set it up.
Yeah, we've all done it before.
I know. But
I know it's a first for you, but we've all done this thing. We've done this
before
multiple times.
I've done it before, too. You know what? I can never get it. You did it. I'm over this. Bye.
Oh, God. Really? It's Friday. Thank you.
Oh, wow. You know what you get instead of a you did it?
Butter.
I am. I set it up by myself, and that those little boxes.
Prod J.
What'd you do?
So this is the small stuff. So right, I'm driving Wednesday. I had my wipers on in the car. This song comes on. Right? For the whole 4 minute song, the wipers went to the beat of the music. It was the highlight of my week.
Oh, that's his? You did it?
You did it!
No. Yeah, because that's rare. That never happened.
The whole I'm talking like I'm a drummer,
neither does
right?
Riley getting stuff set up like that. Also
you
rare.
Did it.
Moving by myself and setting things up, I think, is a bigger accomplishment than the song coming on.
Eileen.
What'd you do?
I put up my Christmas tree.
You did it!
734.
What'd you do?
I helped get the music together for my uncle's funeral.
Yeah.
You
okay.
did it!
All right.
Maybe he's happy he's dead. Who knows?
What kind of music?
MGK?
That would kill me. 347. It's been 2 weeks now without alcohol, and I'm down 5 pounds.
You did it!
See?
No, really, if you stop drinking alcohol, that's...
I know.
That beer gut's a real thing, man.
Yeah, but Kane, you never drank a lot of beer, right? It was more
doesn't
hard
matter.
Stuff?
Other stuff has calories in it. Everything's got calories in it.
Yeah, no, the Jägermeister's got a lot of calories. Yeah,
that's
like
syrup.
347. Only I can rip on Jäger. You can't.
Okay.
I have you guys on my app today, and I started my new job this week. This is Johnny from New Haven.
You did it!
Congrats, new job, Johnny. And we're on the app. Turn us down, because we might say some stuff that gets you looked at.
He's looking at a $15,000 raise a year.
Hell
you
did it!
Johnny,
that's
call
awesome,
me.
Man.
Where do you work, Johnny?
You did it. 55701, Kane and Corey Show. Kane and Corey Show. Big show today.
Big, big, big show.
Of course, it's Friday, so it's always a big show. We got Friday Fact Check before 7. We'll have a D-bag for you. We'll have Out of Context for you in the 8 o'clock hour. Give you a chance to win $100 today in the 8 o'clock hour with no time to Google. That's our new game, which I excelled at yesterday. I mean, I just kicked ass.
You mean you know the news.
Yes, I know the news.
Congratulations. Your job.
More You Did It's later on. Not Quite News in 5 minutes. Kane and Corey Show.
And now, time for Not Quite News.
Maybe you heard this before, because Thomas Edison and Salvador Dali both claimed that being woken up right after you fall asleep can make you more creative.
Yeah, in my house, it can also make you more dead.
Yeah, what the hell?
Wake me up. Wake someone up right after they fall asleep. Supposed to. A new study found that might be true. Make you more creative. I don't care.
I'm just fighting
not,
you.
I'm not creating that day.
Yeah, you're catching hands.
I don't need to be funny that bad. I don't need to lose my sleep.
Every time that's happened at my house, I'm just yelling. Why am I up?
Seriously. LAPD detective, he's catching some heat for this, but, you know, he's just telling the truth. He's telling people to stay away from Los Angeles right now because the crime is so bad. There's all these smash and grabs and follow home invasion robberies happening out there all around the country, really. And this is what he had to say about it.
My message to anybody considering coming to Los Angeles, especially during the holiday season, is don't. It is really, really out of control. You know, I said it to people before. It's like that movie Purge. You know, instead of 24 hours to commit your crime, these bad people have 365 days.
The Purge, he compared it to. Oh, and also this.
It's sad to say, but it's almost safer to hang out with Alec Baldwin on a movie set than to go shopping in Los Angeles right now. That's how crazy
it is. True. There are videos of broad daylight. This woman walking had her baby in a stroller. She got robbed. These people sitting at a restaurant. They're eating in the middle of the day, and they get robbed. Like, what the hell is happening? No one's doing anything about it.
Yeah, but don't worry. No one was coming in the first place.
To LA?
No,
we're not going.
LA is a you know what hole. Mm. Evil, evil place, that place.
You don't like it.
Nope. Gunman on jet ski. Another place you don't want to go is Cancun. It's happened again.
Even with the cops on the beach. Like,
yes.
They've had cops patrolling the beach to stop this, and
yeah.
It's still happening.
Five gunmen pulled up on a beach of the, a lot of us go there. The Oasis Palm Resort. I don't know if you've been there. Supposed to be super nice. They pulled up on jet skis in military uniforms, this family-friendly resort, and fired about 20 shots, which is not the kind of shots the tourists expected when they got there. A whole different kind of shot. That's the one I want to be taking.
Yeah.
Jeez. But were they targeted? Because usually in the past couple of weeks and whatnot, that's happened is they target the drug dealers, and they haven't hit anyone in it, like a civilian yet.
Oh, it's like they're there for a reason.
They're targeting people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I get that.
No, I'm saying, but was that the case this time, or did innocent people get shot?
Story doesn't say. No, nobody was hurt.
Okay.
Oh, good,
but
good.
The story is like, I mean, like, do you really want to go there?
No.
I mean, it's Wild Wild West.
I mean, it's immersive.
Hmm?
It's definitely an immersive experience. You get a part of the Mexican, you know, cartel lifestyle.
I almost just swallowed a piece of plastic.
I was wondering what was going on in there.
I just took a sip of water and this blue piece of plastic almost went down my throat.
A piece of plastic almost took Kane out.
Talk about a shot. Somebody keeps pooping on the floor at a Goodwill in Erie, Pennsylvania. And police want answers. They can't. How do you not catch a guy who's pooping? Hold it right there. Oh, I guess you are. How do you not catch a guy who's taking a crap on a floor?
I
don't understand this.
Maybe he's a phantom dumper. I don't get it.
He's done it multiple times.
Phantom at the Goodwill.
Police in Erie looking for answers. He dropped his pants, pooped on the floor at a Goodwill several times. Employees found the fecal matter hidden behind a shovel. In the employee area. A few minutes after he walked back out to the sales floor and pretended to shop. Again, how are you not catching him? He's right there.
That's hilarious. He's just doing
He's like the world's fastest pooper.
Take that to Salvation Army.
Maybe he's got IBS or something.
Get out of Goodwill.
I mean, if you're going to poop in a store, poop in H&M or something.
Oh, no, not H&M.
And poop at the Gap.
Big Lots.
Yeah, they'll be like, no,
Big Lots.
No Big Lots.
Big dumps at Big Lots. Big logs. Big loads.
Ew.
Big Lots.
Keep them coming. What else you got?
That's it. I exhausted all of them.
That's the news.
Not quite.
Vindicated, a.k.a. when an ex reaches out with a text or a card and says, what's up? How are you?
Yeah,
I love that. Oh, what are you coming back for? Yeah.
It's been seven. It's been 9 years.
Nine
years.
It's the Kane and Corey show, by the way. What's been 9 years?
I told you that. I had a.
You told us five minutes ago.
I had
Tell us again.
Ex that just sent me a holiday card via email.
Oh, it's a holiday card.
No, but like this was like a why you send me a holiday card? Like,
seriously, you haven't heard from her for 6 years.
We haven't talked. Last time we talked, she was like, "I wish we never broke up." Here's what happened: we broke up, right? And as we're going through the breakup, I was like, "Listen, you're gonna come to a point where you realize everything I did for you is because I loved you and this and that, and this and that." And she goes, "No, I don't think so." And then she left. Right? 3 months later, she calls me and goes, "You were right. You did love me. You did do all this stuff because you love me. This and that." And she wanted to hang out, and we never got back together because I lost my feelings for her. Like, I didn't care about her anymore. Actually, right. I looked at her, and I wasn't attracted to her anymore.
Flipped the switch, man. Right? It's off.
Oh, is it? It turned me off completely after that. And now she sends me a card, a virtual card that says, "Merry Christmas." Get the hell out of here.
She's probably, here's what's probably happening. She's probably about to maybe, I don't know, get married or something. And so she's throwing the feelers out one last time before it's finalized. She's going to see all the exes. Check it out. Are you sure you don't want to? You not? Oh, no? Okay. And then she turns to her fiance and goes, "Okay, I'm ready now."
Yeah.
Now we can get married.
"Hey, sorry. Got a kid, got a fiance, got a dog. Don't need you."
Did you respond?
Yeah.
Are you going to send her something back?
Yeah,
no, I wouldn't either. I wouldn't respond.
The emoji middle finger.
You've been vindicated with that.
No,
that's enough.
I don't even care. Like,
do you have any regrets breaking up with an ex? This is kind of, where did it go?
There's a ton of them, though.
You text too much, and I lose the text I was about to read. Oh, there it is. 732. "Three of my exes are now doctors, and one of them is a biomedical engineer. As a poor man, I now regret not marrying all of them."
Oh, that hurts.
516. "Sure, I regret breaking up with my ex every time my wife bitches at me."
Oh, wow. Damn.
917. "No. Never took an ex back. An ex is an ex for a reason. I put in everything I have into a relationship, and if it fails, it's because of someone else."
Here's this one, 623. "I was so shy, and I didn't realize two girls wanted to have a threesome with me years ago. They sat on my bed in their underwear, and all I was focused on was trying to hide my
boner."
Yeah.
You can say boner.
Yeah, I didn't know.
You've said boner billions of times.
I know, but like in different contexts.
You wrote a song called Boner.
Yeah, it's true.
All the lyrics were just boner.
He said he regrets it very much.
Yeah.
I would have too.
So does his boner.
You're supposed to use that boner.
How about this, though? A couple went through a divorce, right? And then decided to stay married at the end of it. They were married like 10 years, whatever, decided. They were drunks, and they were going through some other stuff. And then the woman went to see a therapist, and then he joined, and then they decided to see the therapist, a different one to help them co-parent, blah, blah, blah. Long story short, they were like, "Well, you know what? I guess we figured things out, so now we're not going to get a divorce." $100,000 later.
In legal fees?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Yes. They owe their lawyers $100,000. And they're like, "You know what? We don't regret it because it led us back to each other." That debt would cause another fight, which would lead to another divorce.
At some point they're going to be in need of money. Well, maybe not. They might be rich if that doesn't bother them.
It doesn't seem like they are. I mean, they're in debt to their lawyers.
$100,000?
So. How does it... I mean, at some point, though, like, if you don't have the money, what are you battling it out for? You know, just like sign the papers and get it over with. We can't afford a $100,000 divorce. Who can?
It shouldn't be that hard, right?
No.
No, because people, you know, the resentment, and they want to take what they want, and they don't want the other partner to get what they want. You know what I mean? Like, I think there's a lot of back and forth in divorces and all that.
Ugh.
201, "I broke up with an ex who I dated for 5 years and met my now husband a week later. Safe to say there's no regrets."
Oh, well, good for you.
Well, people are texting in 917, 201. Maybe Corey's ex heard his story yesterday, how you want to see other people. Remember you said that about
Alicia?
Did they
hear the story where I said it out of anger and I didn't actually mean it?
I know, but hey, she could have heard that differently.
No, I doubt. I made it pretty plain and clear how I regretted saying that, and I was sorry for it.
201, "No regrets." More like, "Geez, where would I have been with all these high school sweethearts? Her parents were nuts, drunks, and abusive, and she still lives at home 21-something years later." Yeah, I wouldn't regret that either.
631, "My ex just reached out to me months ago. She probably just wants to steal more of my stuff." She stole from you?
Yeah, like hoodies and
stuff.
My high school girlfriend, I regretted breaking up with her 5, 6, 7 times.
Yeah, but she cheated
on you. We kept getting back
together.
We kept getting back. That was just a stupid high school relationship, though. You know how dumb those are.
She had a baby with Bubba.
She did. I know.
And you wanted to get back with her?
I did once briefly, even after that.
You helped take care of the kid?
No.
I think you just like hanging with her mom.
She was pregnant. She wasn't showing yet.
Oh.
And so I was kind of like, okay. But then once, you know, I'm like, Once you started seeing the visual every day of like, that's not yours.
You wanted to give the baby a dimple.
It's like, what the hell am I doing?
Oh my God, Corey.
Huh. That's how dimples are made.
No, it's not.
Yeah, in the womb.
Yeah, no, it is. Not. He got two.
Stop it.
Yep. Repetitive.
Dum, dum, dum. I gave him a birthmark, too.
Right on the chin.
Oh, my God.
You got, there's two types of babies. Babies that block it and babies that get dimples.
Kane and Corey Show. You see the buzzer beater last night? What a hell of a game. Number one, Purdue got knocked off by Rutgers. Half court buzzer beater, 70-69.
Who watches college basketball before March Madness?
I do.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Are you
serious?
College basketball?
Yeah.
Before March Madness?
Uh-huh. Well, you know, here's when I start to get into college basketball. When, like, football starts to wane. When the Vikings are eliminated from the playoffs.
All right.
Like, as long as there's, like, football still going on, then I'll put college basketball to the side. But then I pick it up.
All right.
I like that word buzzer beater.
Yeah, it's a good one, right?
What is a buzzer beater? Oh, they just win.
He scored the winning basket. He beat the buzzer.
Right,
before the buzzer. Let's do this.
Friday, fact check with Kane and Corey. Sometimes they're right, but usually not. Let's call them out all the time that they are wrong.
Fact check.
All right, let's see what we got wrong this week. I'm sure we got more wrong than this, but this is what producer Jay caught. And you too. You text us with things too. 55701.
I'll tell you what. You say that, but you guys have been really good. Again,
oh
I catch
God.
The ones here. I'm telling Riley, you're always wrong. So we just eliminate that.
I'm never on this.
I mean,
you never put me on this.
That's because
don't
we could,
that
we would have
wrong.
A 7-hour bit, Riley.
Oh my God.
I mean,
what is up his?
All right, let's see who's the most wrong or wrongest, as I like to say. Let's start. We got three pieces here. Let's start with three.
Kane's very well decorated already.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not even done with it.
Yeah, I saw that. I've got five ornaments. You've got the whole thing ornamented.
Man. Oh. Making up words. Wrong. Ornamented?
Yes, that's a new thing I did.
It's a new thing you did?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't catch this.
Ornamented.
You've never heard of ornamented?
Was it a hashtag or was it something you did?
No, I got it. I actually went to Webster's Dictionary. I called them up and I said, I've got a great idea for a word. And they said, if you get enough people to use the word ornamented, we'll put it in the dictionary.
Oh.
So you and who else?
So we'll just scratch that one off the list then.
Yeah, ornamented.
Ornamented.
What's ornamented is when you've decorated and you've completely put ornaments on your tree.
I think the word you were looking for is ornamentated.
No, ornamented.
No.
No, you took ornaments and you put all over your tree and you ornamented it.
We got to bring back words with Corey. We have to keep a list of words that he makes up. That would be a 7-hour bit.
I'm dying by
that. What's next?
The woman in the house across the street from the girl in the window.
That's not going to hashtag well.
No. Nope. Whoever announces that at the Grammys is going to be like, son of a bitch.
Oh, that's not going to win anything.
Grammy?
Yes. I stand by that, too.
So the Grammys are for music.
Let me explain.
All right, go ahead.
Well, let me tell. Jay will tell you the truth first, and then you can explain.
Okay, go ahead. Tell me.
The Grammys are for the music,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
The Emmys
are for television.
Right. Go ahead.
Did you realize that the girl next door to the blah, 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 blah has an amazing soundtrack? So, it's going to win a Grammy for the soundtrack.
I think you might have something there. If there's
ass.
A soundtrack, it could win.
Right.
Like, but like, you know, but that's okay. No, I didn't give it to you 100%.
Yeah.
You thought about that all night,
Go ahead,
didn't you?
Call me a weasel, because I'll get out of it. I'll weasel right through.
All right, what's the number one?
It's in London!
6-hour flight.
Top tour in London.
Unless you take the Concorde.
Yeah, the Concorde hasn't been around. I said yesterday 10 to 15 years.
I think it's longer.
And a listener actually texts me and goes, it's 18. I'm like, really? 3 years? I think 15 is a pretty good roundabout number. But yeah, so no, the Concorde hasn't flown for 18 years.
What you guys don't realize is I got a friend named Vlad who's got a private jet who he named Concorde. Which is so fast. So if you get on his private jet, you'll make it there in no time.
You know what?
It's scary
so
how fast
all three
you
of these you can really throw out because it's bullcrap.
I'll tell you what, out of all the weeks we've done this and your rebuttals, this is the best week in rebuttals that you've had.
These are really, I mean, these excuses all made me pause and go, what?
Really?
I'm going to call Vlad right now. That was at work. Sorry, Vlad. I would call him, but.
We'll call him later.
Oh, my God.
The Kane and Corey Show. Kane and Corey Show is up. 55701. Number to text. What's up, New York, Detroit, and Miami, South Florida? 888-923-0923. I actually have a request from House Guest Lisa to do this douchebag.
House Guest Lisa is Kane's friend who moved in when the lockdown started in March of 2020. She's still there.
Yeah.
Does this make Kane a
Kane, the D-Bag Baby with Kane and Corey.
Okay, yeah, so Ask Guest Lisa was like, you ask, do a D-Bag tomorrow and find out who the D-Bag is. Me
or you.
You
guys actually had a battle?
Yeah, all right, so... Well, she lives with me, of course, and I got a tree. I bought a new tree. She's the one who wanted a tree. I said I didn't want to put a tree up this year because they're a pain in the ass. Whatever. I wasn't feeling all Christmassy.
Yeah.
So I put the tree up, bought a new one. It's nice, whatever. I lug all the stuff up from the basement, the decorations and stuff. Yep. I decorate it for the most part, and I leave some other decorations for her to do, right?
Okay, yeah.
I text her Monday or Sunday, whatever it was, and I said, look, there's the rest of the decorations. Finish the tree. Because I didn't want to hog it. You know, we share the house, we share the tree. I don't want it to be my tree, right?
Okay.
So I'm like, go ahead and finish it whenever you want, and, you know, whatever. It, like, the stockings are on the couch, you got to put them up, whatever. But, like, here we are Friday, everything is still where it was. There's no progress on the tree. All the decorations are still just like, it's almost Christmas, and it's like, it's a mess in the living room. It's all half done, okay? And I said, look, either put them up or take the stuff in the basement. Well, you brought it up. I'm like, yeah, but it's here for you to finish. And if you're not going to finish it, I'll finish it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this mess is here because of you.
I got a
question. Put it in the basement. Get rid of it then. If you don't want to decorate it, get rid of it.
Why didn't she bring it up from the basement? Because she wanted it.
She hates going down there.
So she was afraid to go down to the basement to pick it up.
Yeah, it's too
yucky. So basically, she forced you to bring it up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Or it wasn't going to get done.
Then it's on her now.
Yeah.
You did her a favor by bringing everything upstairs.
Because I didn't want to see what would happen if I just did the whole tree and everything by myself. And then she goes, well, you didn't leave anything for me.
Wait, Kane, when did you bring up the tree again?
I put it up 2 weeks ago.
It's been put up.
I was about to say, give it the weekend again, you know, like this weekend, because she works during the week. Maybe by the end of this weekend, she still hasn't.
Everybody works during the week.
I know, but what I'm saying is maybe she wants to do it on the weekend.
Tell me she can't find 30 minutes to put on a TV show and hang some damn ornaments. I got a damn toddler running around the house, and we still did it. And we both work. Alicia does. We do videos. I do the radio. I do all this stuff. Go to the playground every single day. Somehow found time. You mean house guest Lisa that just has one job? Doesn't pay any rent, can't put up some damn ornaments.
She has two jobs. She does work hard, but still, I mean, like, you know, at least let me know that I'm not going to do anything, and so I would have cleaned up the mess. It's just one of those stupid, typical fights that you have when you live with someone. That's all.
Why did she ask you to get it in the first place if she doesn't want to do it?
Well, that's kind of a pain in the ass.
That's what sucks. It's like, now that you have to, now you're going to have to get it and bring it back down, even though you were the one that didn't want to do it.
She probably knows that it makes Kane feel good, having the tree and the holiday spirit, so maybe
What? She doesn't know. That's not how
she
thinks.
About it all the time, how the tree's so lovely, makes you feel all warm inside, and how you want the lights on when you come home.
She doesn't want the tree, so I feel that way.
She probably realized you're nicer with the Christmas
tree.
So she was like, let's go get the Christmas tree. You're nicer when you have it.
She's like, Kane's happier. Let me ask him to get the tree out.
All right, what do you think? 5-6-5-5-7-0-1. 561 says she's the D-bag. 917 says she gots to go. 862, Lisa's the D-bag. 732 says Kane's completely married.
No, that's you're 100% in a marriage.
914, if she's afraid of the basement, then you have to bring it back down. Why?
It's not fair.
First of all, she's not six, and there's nothing in the basement to be afraid of.
The boogeyman.
I mean, if anybody shouldn't go down there, it's me, because the basement's so short that I got to walk down there like this.
Yeah,
gotta be
all really?
I can't even stand up straight in the basement, or I hit my head on the seat. It's a very old building.
Oh, no.
973 thinks you should get her a Christmas gift, but the Christmas gift is an eviction notice.
Oh.
There it is.
You know, wouldn't that be funny? I should find out, like, online or something, print out one, like, those pink eviction slips that you get on the door.
Yeah.
You probably never had one before. Ooh, and then I should chain her door shut, too.
No, I haven't had one before. No, you're right.
Put a chain on it just for fun.
Just chain her door shut? Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. You
until
ain't
she
back
gets
in there.
Until she gets the ornaments put up.
718, this is on Lisa. Sorry, house guest Lisa, but you lose this one. 862. Wow, okay. Thank you, guys.
I don't think
that.
I've seen one person call you a D-bag so far.
Here's one. 516, Kane, D-bag.
Yeah, 845 says stop complaining. I understand it's annoying, but like, she's a roommate. What can you do?
I guess it runs in the... Never mind.
What?
Nothing.
There's no family.
No, he's trying to get at me.
Oh, I was reading text.
I just don't understand how
something.
You can agree with that.
I don't agree with it. I was just trying to see it on her perspective. Like, maybe she's busy.
Her perspective
she's like
is
this weekend.
Lazy.
Maybe she knows that Kane likes it, like Kane likes to decorate.
No. You got the man to run downstairs to get the stuff that you wanted, right? You wanted it, he got it for you. You asked him to do it, he did it. Now it's just sitting there, and you're going to want him to put it back away, too? That's messed up. That's not something you do.
516 says, who's house guest Lisa? I don't think you've ever mentioned this to the audience.
What?
I hope that's sarcasm.
I think it is, because we've got the whole little thing we play.
Yeah, this thing. It's all the pre-recorded thing.
House guest Lisa is Kane's friend who moved in when the lockdown started in March of 2020. She's still there.
She's a lady that owns a house in Staten Island and doesn't want to drive to Staten Island.
Yeah, they know. They know. But producer Jay, officially, what are you seeing?
For who? Lisa or
me,
you?
Me. For me.
Not a D-bag.
Thank you. Wait, what about for Lisa?
D-bag.
Crap, crap, crap on
if you're sick of all the same old Christmas specials and movies and whatnot, you've seen them 100 times. Here's a long-forgotten one that you might want to pop in.
It's snowing! It's snowing! It's snowing! Did I mention it was snowing? Let's go out and play in the snow!
Great!
Let's go! It's snowing! It's snowing!
What's?
I love Pee-wee so much.
Pee-wee Herman.
You didn't know that was Pee-wee Herman?
No. I thought it was a Muppet.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
From 1988, wow. Pee-wee's Playhouse Christmas special has been remastered, and you can see it now. Cher is on it, and Grace Jones.
I like the one movie that's where Pee-wee plays with his wee-wee.
That wasn't a movie. That was real life.
Oh, that was at the movies.
That was at the movies?
Oh.
Yeah. The soundtrack won an Emmy.
What's he shaking there? Is he shaking a yoo-hoo?
He's shaking a yoo-hoo.
The soundtrack won.
Hey, Jussie. Jussie, you're guilty. We all knew you were guilty. Yeah. This was just the biggest waste of everyone's time, this whole trial, right?
I lived in Chicago during this time, too. And where he say he got beat up and that all that happened, I was like, there's no way that happened where he said it happened.
Guilty
no
verdicts
way.
On 5 of 6 charges. He faces 3 years in prison, but it remains to be seen if he'll actually do any time behind bars. He was like, of course, if you don't know, he claimed he was attacked by 2 men. They punched him. They kicked him. They used racist and homophobic slurs and threw chemicals into his face and wrapped a rope around his neck. You know, the first couple signs that he was lying were the fact that he was in his apartment and he still had the rope around his neck and he never dropped his Subway sandwich.
Yeah.
And he went out on the coldest night in Chicago. You had a Subway craving that bad,
like
you just had to go out. Yeah, yeah. And then we had, I think we had surveillance video or pictures of
the brothers
buying the things. Yeah. Right. He was telling them where to buy it and where to go.
They gave him up real fast. The brothers, they were oh yeah, he told us to do it. Yeah, he paid us.
100%.
Real quick.
Jury took 10 hours to find him guilty. And I'm guilty of watching this show, and I shouldn't have yesterday. I just wanted, because in case you were curious, I want to let you know about the show. The Sex and the City revival.
Yeah, no one's curious.
Have you watched it? I keep seeing clips from it.
I watched the first 2 episodes yesterday afternoon.
I heard someone die.
And just like that. Yeah, spoiler alert.
This is a big spoiler.
So if you don't want to know, earmuffs. But yeah, in the first episode, she's still married to Mr. Big, right?
Yeah.
And at the very end... she's at something for Charlotte's kid, some piano thing, and then he stays home and does this big workout on the Peloton, and then he dies of a heart attack. He gets off the Peloton and then has a heart attack.
People kept saying it's Charlotte's fault.
And then Charlotte's being Charlotte, and she blames herself, and she can't stand it, whatever. The whole second episode is about the funeral. It's just such a bad show.
Elvis.
It's just
Elvis.
So bad.
Elvis, huh? Calm down. Oh, sorry, your name's Kane.
Oh, Elvis.
What are we doing? Are we talking about the damn synopsis?
Well,
I do have a question.
It was a big show.
What?
It was, especially
here. No, my fiance and her 5 friends got together in their pajamas last night and watched it.
Yeah, exactly. It's a big show. This is the last time we'll talk about it. I just wanted to say that, look, I watched it, and you shouldn't because it's really bad.
What man? You tell me what man watches Sex and the City.
Okay, not all our listeners are men, Corey. There's a lot of women out there that watch it.
I understand,
your fiance and 5 friends watched it.
I'm talking about Kane right now.
Kane was on Sex and the City.
It doesn't matter. You don't hang on to it. It's a damn cliff.
It was a good show.
Just an episode. That's not why I'm talking about it. I'm just curious. I watched it because I was curious.
You're going to watch it again.
Wait,
no, I'm done. I'm out.
Can I have one question before we finish this?
Sure.
What happened to Samantha? Like, why, what did they say about her?
They didn't kill her off on the show.
Okay, that's good.
They did chop her up pretty good, though.
They did her dirty?
They said that Carrie didn't need her as a publicist anymore.
Ooh.
So she fired her, and then Samantha didn't like it, so then she cut off all three of the girls. That's what they said happened.
Oh, wow.
They're like, oh, did you text her? I text her. I tried to get a hold of her, but Samantha's not getting back to us, blah, 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 blah. So that's how they dealt with Samantha.
I'd rather watch Drew Barrymore's talk show than hear this right now.
Corey,
I'd rather be Wendy Williams' co-host than talk about Sex and City so in-depth. You guys are giving synopsises and...
It was like 2 minutes, not even. 30 seconds.
It was brief. And a lot of people were looking forward to the stupid reboot, and here it is.
718. I just turned on the show and heard you guys talk about Sex and the City. I thought I was listening to The View.
Look, 201. My husband watched it with me last night.
There we go.
Because you forced him to.
Really?
Threatened to change the
locks. You think he couldn't have got up off the couch?
Threatened to change the locks.
You watched The Kardashians.
Yeah, Corey.
Oh, yeah.
With my eyes closed.
Good. Corey's complaining about Sex in the City, but he doesn't know who Jack White is, says 201. Yeah, I mean, you know, we can go after you for a lot of things. Yeah. I'm just letting you vent. I'm just letting you rant. And that's fine. And I understand what you're saying about it, because, I mean, it's Sex in the City.
201, it's unbelievable, but I'm agreeing with Corey.
Yeah, no, I get you.
I don't know, man. I'm sorry. I felt like... I had to stand up for some people.
Kane and Corey show. Are you good at catching people in lies? A lot of people like to feel that like to believe that they're really good at knowing whether people are lying or not.
I feel that way. I feel like
you
I
feel
got
that way.
Sense of yeah.
Sense of when someone is not telling you the truth.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Riley, do you feel that way? Riley.
Riley.
Oh God.
You guys have my thing off during the thing, so I can't hear y'all.
Neither can Jay, but somehow he knows
Somehow he knows when we're on.
Because I have to always keep up looking at the light, man. What are you guys talking about?
He'll try to catch up. Here are the three surefire ways to tell if someone is lying to you, right? Which I will tell you in just a second. You're going to need these for the rest of your life. But I'm going to use them on Corey first. I'm going to ask you.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I'm going to ask you five random questions, Corey.
Invasive questions?
And I will be, maybe. And ooh. I will be able to tell. It wouldn't be fun otherwise. And I will be able to tell if you are lying or not by these three surefire ways to tell when someone is lying to you, which I will share when we're done.
Okay. Maybe I have a thumbtack on my toe right now, and I'm going to press it every time I answer so I get the same response every time.
Hey, whatever you got. Do you really love fiance Alicia?
Yes.
Okay, I believe you. I'll explain why.
Did you ask if I was in love or did I love? Okay.
Have you ever been with a man?
No. Not yet.
Those are...
No, never.
He said not yet.
And then you get mad when people text you stuff like, bye.
That's fine.
Not yet.
No, I've never had. No, never been with a man.
I don't believe you.
Why you don't?
I think he just doesn't want to believe you.
He doesn't want exactly.
Have you ever wanted to kill someone?
Yes.
Whoa.
I believe you.
You've never been so angry. You're like, I wouldn't have. You're not going to do it, but come on. I'm a human.
Have you ever wished you were a girl?
No. I've pretended to be a girl, but I've never wished I was a girl.
Okay. I believe you. And do you shave your legs?
I have. Yes.
Yeah, all right, 100%. All right. Actually, you know what?
It's hard to play this game with me because I'm a very honest person.
Yeah, no,
I
believe you. I think I believe you in pretty much all of these. Here are the three surefire ways, though, according to this, tell someone's lying to you. Now, you did this for all five of these, but I know it was earnest the way you were doing it. They stare right at you. Honest people look away to think about their answer.
I feel like that's supposed to be the opposite.
But I think that's why I think they catch, because liars will try to convince you they're not lying by staring into your eyes. They think it's more convincing.
Okay. Huh.
See? So maybe that's why you were staring into my eyes.
Yeah, I lied to you about everything. I don't love my wife. I love men. I don't shave my legs.
Wait, can you say that again real quick? Nobody laughs. Nobody said go. One more time and go.
And then the other surefire way, two more. The second one is they repeat the question. I was waiting for you to do that.
Nah.
But that why to buy time?
Yeah, because they want to think about their answer.
To think of an answer.
If you're going to tell the truth, say it right away.
Really?
Because if you know the truth, you just say it right away.
And then the last one was they swear. according to reports, people use five times more profanity when they're lying. If you, telling a story, you know.
I'm not shaving my damn legs.
Yeah, I was looking for that.
No. Yeah,
right, right.
I used to actually. I've used Nair on my legs before too.
Nair, really?
Yeah.
Right now, every woman's in the car and goes, "My husband does this."
Well, listen. He goes. He said, "Not yet about being with a guy." He said he shaves his legs. And the 561 goes, "And you mock people for watching Sex in the City?"
I haven't shaved my legs in so long. That was in high school. I wasn't mocking.
Would it like be faster?
I'm just saying it's not. That's not, you know, on par for the show. Is Sex in the City?
All right. See if you can tell if I'm lying.
Okay.
I'm gonna tell you a quick story. So this morning, as I go to sit on the toilet. Mm-hmm. I stepped in cat vomit, mm-hmm. right, with my socked foot.
Yep.
And I didn't feel like changing socks, so all I did was wipe the vomit off of my sock. Mm-hmm. It did soak through to my foot, yep. But I'm wearing the socks right now.
Yeah, it seemed like you were, as I peered into your eyes, it seemed like you were thinking, and you were trying to come up with something. So I'm not gonna, I don't believe that one. I believe it's happened to you, but not today.
And the way that you did with your pen, like you were kind of jittery as you were talking.
Well, I mean, not so much that as it was his eyes. I could tell we're looking for something.
Oh, I can't see his eyes.
It's absolutely true.
Yeah, wait, really?
I was going to say,
that
you sounded...
Today?
Yeah.
I sat down on the toilet, my right foot went into some vomit, and I'm like, for the love, and I like the socks I'm wearing, so I just wiped it off, and I decided to suck it up.
You know this is true?
What?
You're nasty as hell.
That's so gross.
That is kind of
so
nasty.
Gross.
Jesus.
For Not Quite News.
Do you ever break something while having sex?
Yes.
Ever destroy something whilst in...
I'm trying to think. Like, maybe from the transition from the living room to the bed and, like, putting someone down too hard and broke a little the plank. One
wow.
of the planks.
Mm-hmm. Oh, like the slat?
Yeah,
the wooden slat underneath the mattress?
I broke a bed. I broke a couch.
Yeah, I can see that.
And you were by yourself.
You're just jealous because you don't get any.
Sorry.
He's just jealous because I'm getting sex on the reg. It's okay.
That was a wide open shot, though. I mean,
Jesus.
Drain that one. This woman is a Florida woman. A couple of Florida stories. Florida ladies. She and her buddy. They say it's... The story doesn't say, but they... it appears to be a male. They went into a bathroom at a restaurant and eatery in Seminole, Florida. Irish 31. Don't know if you've been there. But they destroyed a sink. They got intimate and tore a sink off the wall.
Damn.
Wow.
He probably did one of the things where, like, you know, he threw her up on the sink with her butt, and then the sink probably just came off the wall.
That, or she thought that the sink could support her. Maybe she was a little bigger, and she sat on the sink, and it just came off the wall.
No, that's sinks, pretty much
no,
what I said.
That's literally what Kane said.
I know, but he said that it was the guy's fault. I'm saying that she thought she was.
No, I didn't say it was anybody's fault. I just said they were probably having sex on the sink, and that's how it happened.
Well,
that's all.
Of course, that's how it's going to happen. How else would it happen?
She's being blamed, but he's not. That's funny.
Well, that makes sense.
They. The people asked them to leave, and they went to the bathroom to see. Because they were just causing a ruckus.
Yeah.
And the employees there were like, "You'll have to leave." And then they went to the bathroom and saw that they had destroyed the place.
Damn.
And so now they're looking for her for sink destruction.
What she looks like? Is there a picture of her?
I can't see it. Her name is Catherine Trammell. Catherine with a K. $500 in damages.
Catherine Trammell? More like Catherine Trample your bathroom.
God. Wow, that went over like a fart in church. You were struggling. The struggle with it was the funniest part. Hey, man, you don't hit a home run unless you step up to the plate.
You gotta try. Catherine Trammell's the lady, the villain from Basic Instinct, too. By the way,
you drilled yourself into the ground on that one. Yeah. Swung so hard.
Whatever.
76-year-old woman vandalized a car. Now get this. She's 76. This sounds like something you would do when you're 17, maybe. She broke up with this dude, right? 76-year-old woman named Patsy. She flipped out and vandalized their cars. She crashed her car into his, poured oil over the air vents, and wrote stuff like "loves kinky sex" and "womanizer" in pink lipstick on the windows. Then Patsy went over to the girlfriend's car, poured oil all over it, and put a dead raccoon on the hood. And she also wrote "slut" in pink lipstick.
It was Patsy.
It was a BMW, and it was damaged so bad that it was a total loss.
Go
she ruined
sit
it.
Sit down. You're so old. Go watch a show.
Wait, why are you saying this to her? I love this.
She's 75 how years old.
She's acting like a teenager.
17, 75, girl, do you.
No way.
Are you doing go defacing, damage cars?
She's defacing property.
She cracks me up.
What's even happening here?
Cracks you up? This guy's car is totally ruined.
The boyfriend, 74, is he's got a young one. She's 64. The new girlfriend, whose car was totaled.
Ooh.
Golly, now you gotta worry about... How do you, girl?
It's lipstick. You can wash it off.
It's a total... The BMW is a total loss.
It's totaled. She totaled the car.
Yeah, I'm doing this.
Yeah, what the hell? Welcome to the Kane and Corey Show. We promote illegal activities.
Well, now sometimes. we found a purpose for the Island Boys.
What are we doing?
An actual purpose for them. They're on Cameo, and a Twitter user used them to quit his job.
Hey, Ron, just wants to let you know that Robert doesn't want to work here anymore because they're Island Boy. I'm going to keep it on my Island Boy. Just underscore D-O-N-N-N-N-E underscore with them. Want to leave with flame. My asshole. Just wanted to let you know that Robert doesn't work here anymore because his Island Boys, yeah, just quitting his job, yeah. He with the Island Boys.
Yeah.
You don't want to be with no more. You want to be an Island Boy.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's over now.
I don't know what's worse. Patsy or those guys?
I was thinking about using them.
Really?
They're making money on Cameo, dude. They've done everyone's stuff.
We're never going to come to a point in life from now on where we don't remember them. Remember back in 2021, late 2021, those weird dudes, the Island Boys?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
They're forever with us. That's the news.
Not quite.
It's beginning to look a lot like F this. Have you seen that viral video?
Absolutely.
Oh, my God. Usually it's about the snow.
Yeah.
But this, we'll focus on money here. It's Kane and Corey Show, by the way. Thank you for being there. 55701, number to text. I have here the holiday tipping guide.
Oh, son of a bitch. Well, you...
You got it. You got to tip people. Wow. You got first of all, you got to tip extra people, and you've got to tip the same people extra.
How are you supposed to? Where are you getting all this money from?
I don't know, man. Well, what do you really? You?
I still have bills and expenses to pay for.
I know, but you got $20 here and there, $30 here and there.
Not for the 8 people that they sent me on the valet list, and then the 10 people in the building, and now the postman, and now... Go ahead, read the list, Kane.
Well, hang on, isn't that funny, though, how because you said off the air, isn't it funny how it comes up? Like, you don't know any of their names, like the guys in the parking garage, you know, Hector and Nestor and whatever their names are, except for right now. Wait, I think that was a Christmas donkey, wasn't it?
Nestor?
except for right now, all of a sudden you get a like card with all of their names
exactly.
on it, like tapping you on the shoulder going, don't forget about giving me money this year.
You never see these people, not once.
Guys, this happens every year. This should not be a surprise.
This is a surprise for me. I never had I never had a garage before. This is my first year with a garage.
Well, yeah. See, now I tip garage people. Well, at least when I lived in the city, I tipped garage people every time I would get my car, so I never gave them money at the end of the year.
Every day? I'm not tipping these people. I pay $700 a month to park there. I'm not tipping them every day.
Oh, I hear you. That's what you know. We just have different methods.
I'm paying their salaries.
But if you don't pay them every day, then I think you should tip them at least a little bit.
No, I plan on tipping them, but I didn't know there was damn 8 of them. Where'd they come from? I only deal with 2 guys every time.
I was going to say, so only tip them.
Yeah,
what are you tipping
8.
The guys you don't have to deal with for?
I don't know why they sent me the list of the entire staff.
Because you probably don't know the names of the 2 that you deal with.
Well, they didn't put them next to a picture, so I still don't know their names.
All right, so here's the tipping guide as far as experts say. If you've got a child care provider, you're supposed to give a $50 tip.
Wow, I never got that.
Child care
when I nannied.
Nope. You're supposed to tip like your teachers and stuff now?
Teacher's not on the... Oh, yeah, it is. Yeah, you're supposed to tip your teacher $25.
Oh, my...
No way. I'm sorry. No way in hell. My parents, they never would have been able to afford tipping a teacher.
No.
And besides, half the teachers suck. I'm sorry. Apologies. I know you got to talk... Whatever. But you're not all good. Not everybody is good at what they do.
No, that's
and
true.
I had some horse-ass teachers that didn't deserve a penny. Well, so, you just got to go around, tip them all $25?
You were also a pain in the ass student.
No.
So, on top of the $2,000 a month you pay for daycare, you got to tip each one of the...
Apparently, that's crazy. My parents only tip, the best, not the best one, but the one that the one that helps your son the most.
That's got to be rich people stuff, man. My parents never tip nobody.
Yeah, like a gift card.
Housekeepers, you're supposed to tip $50.
Okay, I understand that.
That's understandable, sure. Because, you keep my house clean.
And they don't do it for that much. It's not that expensive for them.
If you have a landscaper, Miami, you probably do a lot of people there, $30.
All right, that's again,
that seems reasonable.
Doable. Yeah, why not?
You're supposed to even tip the mailman. I don't know if you knew that.
The damn mailman!
$20.
You put it in the mailbox.
For what? Do you see their pensions and their health care and all their benefits? And I'm tipping them? Jay doesn't even make as much as the damn mailman.
No, I'm going to leave him a tip envelope in my mailbox for him to leave me money.
I'm going to hit you with a full disclosure as soon as this conversation's over. All right?
What is that?
I'm just going to hit you with some reality when the whole thing is over. We'll leave on that. You're supposed to tip your garbage man $20.
Okay.
Oh. Really? You're okay with that?
I don't ever see him, so there's no chance.
Yeah, I don't know. You're supposed to tape,
down the garbage
tape it to the can?
Yeah.
In my case, the bag? Yeah. We where I live, they take the garbage every day, which is amazing. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Whoa.
You can throw out anything every day.
I was in Florida when I lived in St. Pete.
Couch, air conditioner, bulk, it
right
doesn't matter.
Right on the curb.
I'm
coming to your house to drop some stuff off. Jeez.
It's pretty amazing. And then here are the people that you're supposed to tip extra. You tip your bartenders and your coffee shop baristas. Well, I never tip them. You know what? Anybody with a cup with a piece of paper taped to it that says tips and a smiley eye, I'm not tipping you. No, that's your job. Like the guy at the bodega. I'm not tipping you for ringing my paper up.
You're tipping everyone else, though.
No, that's coming in the full disclosure.
Okay.
Food delivery person, you're supposed to tip extra. All these people, you're supposed to tip extra.
I got a question.
Your hairstylist.
We do a service. Where the hell's our tip? Should we set up a Venmo for our tips?
That's a good idea, Corey.
We provide daily ha-has.
Yeah. At least we try to.
Seriously.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, we deserve extra. We deserve tips. That's a good idea. You know what? I'm going to write it on the back of my Jeep window.
Hey,
I'm
going to
put my Venmo on there. Yeah. Why not?
PayPal.
55701. Would you tip us if we had a Venmo?
Would you tip us?
That's so sad.
Let's start a Patreon. Maybe you could tip us every month.
Yeah. Well, we'll start the Patreon soon enough. But my full disclosure, I'm talking about all these. I've never once tipped anybody anything for Christmas. I've never given the mailman anything. I've never tipped the parking garage guys. I just don't. No, I don't do it.
Last year, I gave all the people in the building Starbucks cards.
Did you?
Yeah,
that's more than I've ever done.
No.
Garbage man, nobody. I've just
Riley,
never tipped.
When you don't come from money, you don't know these things. You're not accustomed to it.
Yeah,
I had no idea.
I had no idea I was even supposed to.
Okay, that's one thing. But, Kane, you've had money for years and years and years.
I come from money.
No.
I don't come from money.
That's the point. The point is you've lived in New York City.
Yes, but we don't know the rules. When I first was moved, when someone moved me for the first time, I didn't know I was supposed to tip them. I showed up to the house I moved into with a bunch of broken stuff. Why? Because they didn't get tipped. I had no idea.
Yeah.
I was not accustomed to this because my parents didn't tip nobody except for the waiter.
Only people I thought ever begged for money were people who didn't have anywhere to live.
Yeah.
Homeless people.
Kane and Corey Show.
What's up? This is the highlight right now of Jay's week, producer Jay's week, because we get to play his intro, the one that you've chosen that you like the best for Out of Context. Out of Context, I think Jay explains it pretty well.
Kane and Corey say things that make you really question your life, your love, and even who you're sexting. They can take anything and turn it into sex. It's Kane and Corey's Out of Context.
Let me see you swallow.
No.
Let me see you spit.
See, now, unintentionally, it sounds like that. Because, if you remove what happens before, what happens after, then it becomes out of context.
We say some things, and a lot of things we say come off to be dirty, even though they're not dirty.
Yeah, so listen to these, because you got to vote which one of these five goes in the Ook Hall of Fame after we're done, the Out of Context Hall of Fame. All right, let's start, Producer Jay, with number five.
You won't believe who's trying to get up my ass.
I won't. Who is it? Who's trying to get up there?
I think his name was Rick or Jerry. I forget. No, what was the actual context of this?
We were talking about how in the meeting the other day, Showkiller Mike got up your ass about going to the doctor about your arm, right?
Oh.
About your hand. So yesterday on the air, you said you won't. We were talking about doctors and being afraid, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And you said
you won't believe who was trying to get up my ass.
Is that the only time he's trying to get up there?
And you know it's believable with Chappelle and Mike. So it's, I'm just.
What's the next one?
How'd you get the job, Jane?
Yeah, how'd you come over on this side of the hall?
That was all oral.
Meaning,
I talked my way into the job. another out of context. All right, what's number four?
Sometimes it's too hot.
When was the last time it was so hot you couldn't put your mouth on it?
Play that again.
Sometimes it's too hot.
When was the last time it was so hot you couldn't put your mouth on it?
So hot you couldn't put your mouth on it. Oh, Jesus.
Do you remember the context of that one?
Was it noodles? I don't know.
We were talking about a hot chicken nuggets.
Chicken tendies.
It was from McDonald's.
Yes.
And Corey was pretending. Like, seriously, where you don't get hot. They're never hot. They're maybe lukewarm.
Yeah.
And so that's what we talked about there, yeah. All right, what's next?
Got to be at least 4 inches.
Hold on, let me measure.
Got to be at least 4 inches.
Hold on, let me measure.
Wait, what was this one about? We were talking about scratches on a rental car.
Oh,
right?
Yes.
And a lot of times they want, because you have to go for that photo inspection. That was your FML.
You're walking around the car, and like I'm pointing out scratches, and they're like, oh, no, I won't mark that one down. That's not big enough.
It's got to be over 4 inches.
Got to be at least 4 inches.
Uh-huh. Hold on, let me measure.
What are you going to use as a ruler, huh?
Either. All right, what's next?
I got mine up.
Yeah,
mine's up.
Yours is nice. I saw yours. I got mine up.
Yeah, mine's up.
Yours is nice. I saw yours.
Thank you, Corey.
You're welcome.
I don't even remember having that conversation.
You decorated it really nice.
Yeah, we're talking about, of course, your Christmas tree that you posted in your story or on your IG.
That's right. That's
I don't know what goes on in your studio, but it sounds like you guys are having fun in there. That's all.
Yeah, we do.
His is up. Mine's up.
Yeah. It's exciting in here. All right, what's number one?
Speaking of, here it is.
What'd you do with it? Did you swallow it?
No, you spit that out. It's just disgusting.
I didn't think you were a quitter, Kane.
There's a bit of a theme with this week.
Yeah.
What was the context we were talking about?
I think it was yesterday, the day before, small victories. And one of your small victories was getting a piece of food out of your teeth.
Oh, yes.
Right?
What'd you do with it? Did you swallow it?
No, you spit that out. It's just disgusting.
Yeah, because I swallow it and you spit it on the carpet.
Yeah. I'm not gonna swallow like food that's been stuck in my teeth.
I'm swallowing it.
That's nasty. All right, so text us 55701 with whatever number corresponds to the one that you want to go in the Ook Hall of Fame. Text 54.
You won't believe who's trying to get up my ass.
Text 4 for this one.
Sometimes it's too hot.
When was the last time it was so hot you couldn't put your mouth on it?
Text 3 for this one.
Got to be at least 4 inches.
Hold on, let me measure.
God, text 2 for this one.
I got mine up.
Yeah,
mine's up.
Yours is nice. I saw yours.
We know Kane's favorite.
Text 1, well, because it's complimentary. Text 1 for this one.
What'd you do with it? Did you swallow it?
No, you spit that out. It's just disgusting. All right, which one goes in? Results next. Kane and Corey Show. It's Vance Joy, Missing Piece. Vance Joy, Kane and Corey Show. Okay, so Nista, we just played the top 5 best out of context moments from the week. And you were voting to see which one goes in the Ook Hall of Fame. You had to choose between number 5.
You won't believe who's trying to get up my ass.
Number 4.
Sometimes it's too hot.
When was the last time it was so hot you couldn't put your mouth on it?
Number 3.
Got to be at least 4 inches.
Hold on, let me measure.
Number 2.
I got mine up.
Yeah,
mine's up.
Yours is nice. I saw yours.
And number 1.
What'd you do with it? Did you swallow it?
No, you spit that out. It's just disgusting. It was a very tight race between number 2 and number 1, but at the end, number 2 rised above.
I got mine up.
Yeah,
mine's up.
Yours is nice. I saw yours. Hey, pitched it up there.
I just love that it's complimentary to me.
It's even glittery. It's got glittery.
I know. Thank you for your votes via text. Appreciate that. If you want to win a chance or a chance to win $100, you should call us now. We got a new game called No Time to Google. How are you with like current events and pop culture and things that are happening today? If you can beat me in No Time to Google, you'll win $100. It's that simple.
100 buckaroos.
Yeah, call now 888-923 0923-888-923-0923 if you want to play. We'll play in about 5 minutes, all right? Now, let's try to give away some of the company's cash.
We got one!
Answer the question in a 5 second rule. It's Kane and Corey with no time to Google now. No time to Google now.
Yeah, we got Maria from Brooklyn on the phone. What's up, Maria?
Hey, what's up?
How are you with your pop culture knowledge and stuff that's going on right now, current events? You good?
I'm pretty okay, yeah. Probably not as good as you. I might embarrass myself.
Well, Corey's,
no one's going to embarrass himself more than me on this show, so you'll be all right.
Corey's got 5 questions for us. He's going to ask you first. I'm going to leave the room. We'll see how many you get right, and then I'll come in, and I'll see if I can beat you. If you beat me, we'll give you $100, all right?
Sounds great.
Oh, by the way, I should tell you, too. Ties go to the runner. The home team gets the tie. So if we tie, that you don't win. I win.
Wow.
I love Maria.
But you know what you'll get? The satisfaction knowing that you were as smart as Kane.
And because it's called No Time to Google, you've only got 5 seconds to answer these questions.
All right, let's do this.
You got it? Okay. Maria, by way of BK. Kane, get the hell out of here. What are you still doing here?
I don't know.
You're not needed, dude.
We got to wait for that door to slam.
Yeah, bye-bye.
I don't need to tell you to get out of here. You're a grown man.
There he goes.
All right, Dad's gone. Yeah! All right. Hey, Jay, play the sound. There it is. All right, Maria from Brooklyn, you ready?
All right, let's do it.
First question. Kristen Bell is doing a show on Netflix with a ridiculously long title. What is the name of it?
Oh, my goodness. Oh.
Yeah, that wasn't it.
That was 5 seconds.
That's my feeling.
That's wrong. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Someone paid $450,000 to buy a property and to be neighbors with who in the metaverse? Maria!
Come on, Maria!
Maria! All right, we'll move on to the next one. Move on. It's okay. You still got three. You never know that. All right, here we go. We always talk about airlines on the show, okay? So what airline was just recently consistently rated the worst airline?
I think it was Spirit.
Ding, 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 ding. Congratulations, you got that one right.
That was right.
Yeah, you got that one right. Okay, here we go. Next question. If you don't like your job salary... who wrote these questions?
I did.
If you don't like your job salary, fake a crime like this guy who was just convicted for staging a racial and homophobic attack.
What?
Okay.
I have no idea.
Yeah, okay.
That was a weird way to do that, Jay.
I'm just reading it.
I don't know it. It's okay.
He's got commas in the wrong spot and all kinds of things, but you know what?
I might have sent in the email the wrong way.
Okay. Next question. We spoke about it yesterday on the show, so this is the test to see if you were listening, Maria. Which actor was the most Googled actor of 2021 according to Google Trends?
Oh, this must have been before 8 a.m. because that's what time
it is. Wow.
Maria, you got one question right. Congratulations.
Wow,
well, let's get Kane. Come on in, Kane.
But don't tell Kane.
Kane, she got one right.
Oh, no.
Man. She got one?
Yeah, she got one right.
Yeah,
I was supposed to tell him. That's the way we went.
Yeah, no. Wow. Okay, well, this is going to be easy.
Listen, she tried hard, and that's all that matters, man.
All right. Okay.
I tried hard. I didn't get as lucky as Corey gets on some, you know, our smarter than
Okay. All right. Hey, you never know. Maybe I miss them all. Let's see.
All right, Producer Jay. Kristen Bell is doing a show on Netflix with a ridiculously long title. What's the name of it?
I don't remember. It's the woman in the house, and she's across the street from... I don't know that one.
The title is The Woman in the House Across the Street from the Girl in the Window.
Okay, there's no way I don't remember that one.
Hey, Maria. Things are looking good for you right now.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
All right. Someone paid $450,000 to buy a property that's not even real and be neighbors with who in the metaverse?
Oh, this was a story yesterday.
Oh my God!
There's no way that's 5 seconds.
Yes. That's 5 seconds.
Son of a! I knew it was a rapper.
Hey, that is really a quick 5 seconds. We got it.
That was really fast.
It's five.
Fast.
No, it's five. All right. Listen.
Okay, yeah, we don't, right, don't play it again. We're gonna play it again.
No. We always talk about airlines on the show, Kane. What airline was recently and is consistently rated the worst?
That's easy. Spirit.
You guys both got that one right.
Okay.
That must be the easiest question to ask anybody. What airline sucks the most?
All right, here you go. This is a tough one because of the way Jay worded it.
No, it's not tough. Yes, you're just reading it wrong.
Awkward.
If you don't like your job salary, fake a crime like this guy did, who was just convicted for staging a racial and homophobic attack.
Jesse Smollett.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, here we go. All right, here we go. One more.
Jesse?
Jesse.
I said Jesse.
It's Jesse. There you go.
Yeah. All right. We spoke about it yesterday, Kane, on the show. Let's see if you were listening to your own talkings. Which actor was the most Googled actor of 2021?
Alec
according...
Baldwin.
Here you go.
Yeah.
All right.
Well,
so, Maria. Maria.
Sorry.
Okay. No, thank you guys so much. Are you kidding? Are you sorry?
You know what? What do you do, Maria? What do you do for a job?
I work at a law office in downtown Brooklyn, and I'm also a bartender on the weekend.
Yeah, you make enough money. You're good. All right.
Hey, thanks for calling.
Have a
great weekend.
All right, thank you so much.
Bye, Maria.
Oh, man, I wanted her to beat you. I liked her.
Yeah, eventually it'll happen, I'm sure, but...
Yeah, that was the chance to do it. You got two wrong.
Wow.
That will never happen again.
You knucklehead.
Crap, crap, crap on
crap on Hollywood news today, producer. It's bad. It's all gross.
What happened?
All bad stuff.
Yeah, it's not good.
We'll start with Machine Gun Kelly posting stuff on his Instagram, video of leeches sucking on his chest. Not women. Three actual leeches.
So it wasn't his wife. It wasn't his.
No, three actual, okay, like this thing. I was going to say bugs, but they're not. But they're so gross to fish with. You ever fish with a leech?
They're kind of cool.
No, I don't
try to stick it on
a
hook.
I've never seen a leech in person. Never
really?
Touched one? No.
Google the MGK with the parasites on his chest.
All that's coming up is him and Megan.
He's got parasites probably other places too.
So wait, you fish
just
with leeches?
Feels like it.
Yeah, you can fish with them.
I didn't know that.
It's just Megan Fox on his neck.
It's a good bait. And this is another gross story. I don't even know why I talk about these. It appears Armie Hammer will not be charged with rape following a 9-month investigation.
What?
Yeah.
All those disturbing allegations.
All the text messages and strange things about murder.
Yeah. The woman named Effie said, I thought he was going to kill me, and this, that, and the other, and the blood.
Oh, that happened a long time ago.
He liked her blood. Yeah. So he's not going to be charged. This one's gross. Josh Duggar. Reality show. He's been convicted on child pornography charges. He faces up to 20 years in prison. Please don't ever let him out.
Yeah. Doesn't he have kids?
He's going to die in there because even prisoners don't take kindly to kid diddlers, to pedos.
He's got 19 kids.
19 kids,
he's
and
done.
This guy's doing child porn. Piece of crap.
And I think he did it to his sisters, too. It came out in the stories, yeah.
This story's there is a good one at the end, so bear with me. This one's gross. Marilyn Manson. Allegedly threatened to assault Evan Rachel Wood's son in the most disgusting way that you can think of, and I'm not even gonna tell you what it is. But that is an accusation. Of course, he denies that. DailyMail.com has all the details on that. Should you want to depress yourself and read those. And finally, Homer Simpson, according to the DTLA Law Group in California, all the accidents that he suffered over the 33 seasons of The Simpsons, they looked at 50 well-documented accidents, okay? The multiple broken bones, the head injuries, the animal attacks, the food poisoning.
The liver and kidneys from Duff Beer.
All of that. He would owe $143 million to the hospital.
Yep. I feel like he doesn't have insurance.
Brain damage alone would have cost him $1.5 million at the hospital.
Jeez.
Paralysis,
$508,000. Wow.
Wow, look at him. He found the cure.
Yeah.
What was it, stem cells? How the hell is he walking around? Radiation exposure, which he does on a daily basis, that's $150,000. Yeah. Skull fractures, $100,000. Loss of consciousness, $80,000.
Who do you think would owe more, Peter Griffin or Homer Simpson?
Oh, that is a good question.
Yeah, because Peter Griffin got in a fight with that chicken so many times.
Oh, my God. The chicken fight, the falling down the stairs.
He's always getting hurt.
He buys the rocket ships and crashes. Yeah, I know. That's hard. That's a tie.
Yeah.
That would have to be a tie.
55701. Who do
you... Who would pay more at the hospital? Peter Griffin or Homer Simpson? I'm actually going to go Peter.
Yeah, I think Peter.
Duggar is part of the 19 siblings. He doesn't have 19 kids. He's part of the siblings.
Yeah, he's part of it. Yeah.
Still, what's wrong with you, man?
Glad we can end on a light note.
Yeah. Oh, Homer Simpson.
Katie Couric Show.
Hell yeah!
Happy Friday. What did you get accomplished this week?
You did it. It's another week you've reached the end. You conquered all those dragons. Go and tell your friends. It's Kane and Corey with your victories. You did it again.
You did it.
Live from Bibbidi Babbidi, where you can find apparel at Magic Kingdom.
Don't speak Italian. Nobody understands that.
Bibbidi
Bibbidi Babbidi.
It's called the Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique.
What'd you get done? What'd you get accomplished? What do you want to brag about? 55701, number to text. You can call us 888-923-0923 as well. Let's go to some of the ones on Instagram, on the gram. JoJo.
What'd you do?
Work gave me an early raise.
You did it! Right.
Congratulations.
VeroFab06.
What'd you do?
I called out on Monday after the Audacy, after the Beach Fest.
That's nice.
Excellent. So you had a long 3-day weekend.
Yeah, there you go.
Jeans.
What'd you do?
I finished my Christmas shopping.
Woo. You did it!
It sucks when I miss the button. Yeah. It ruins the flow.
Yeah, you really put us out.
Hey, Corey.
What'd you do?
I got 7 hours of sleep last night.
You did it!
Interrupted sleep, but still.
You looked more tired today than you usually do, though.
I got kicked in the face once by my 4-year-old. Oh. I was woken up by Alicia at one point. Then a phantom wake up at one point as well.
What's a phantom wake up?
You just wake up because the ghost rubs you.
Ah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I don't know what it was. What the hell was that?
Why did Alicia wake you up?
Because she moves around a lot and steals covers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you guys need twin beds.
Yeah. different rooms.
Different rooms.
Different houses.
Riley.
What'd you do?
I just moved last week. So this week I set up my cable. I called for electricity. I did all the adult things. And everything's set up now.
They give you cable at a halfway house?
You did it!
Man, this house is nice. I got my own little apartment.
386.
What'd you do?
I picked up a bunch of overtime to pay my bills.
You did it!
Congratulations.
914. Al, shut up.
What'd you do?
914. I'm going to just stick to one button from now on. I got a job with Tesla and just put a deposit down on my first apartment. That's
amazing.
From Aylin.
That's a good feeling. With that first apartment, when you get approved for it, you put your deposit down. That's an amazing feeling.
954. Got my first Christmas bonus from work.
You did it!
Are we getting Christmas bonuses this year?
Yeah, dude, you're getting a $100 gift card to Red Robin.
I still have the gift card they gave me from last Christmas
if you want it.
Yeah, me too.
It's from that pizza place around the corner.
Mine's to Westville.
I got Westville too.
You got Westville and you haven't used it?
Do you want mine?
Westville's awesome. It's probably expired now, though.
No, it's not. I called.
Why would you give away a Westville? That's a good one.
Yeah, it's a good spot.
I'll switch with you.
I got my Westville one.
I'm never going to go to the Italian place.
Why
it's
not?
Too fancy for me.
Oh, take a date.
Too fancy.
Nah, I got like a bar. I got to have a sports bar.
They got good food there, I'm sure.
It's like a diner, like a nice diner.
No, it's nice, but it's too nice for me. I don't feel comfortable in nice places.
954. They donated. 954.
Oh.
What'd you do?
Jesus. Donated 2 boxes of toys for Toys for Tots.
Oh, my God. 347 lost 30 pounds in 17 days.
You did it!
I've lost 12 in about the past 9 days.
That's good, man.
It's because, Corey pointed out no alcohol, which is probably the biggest reason.
Yeah.
But I've cut out sugar, too.
Yeah.
Like, nice. I haven't been eating crap.
Yeah.
And I haven't been eating because I told house guest Lisa to stop buying food for the house.
Yes.
And so there's nothing in there. And knowing me, I am too lazy to go buy my own food. So I just sit and drink water and get rid of the hunger pains.
Yes. And also, your kidneys are shriveling up to little peas.
Yeah, that too.
You did it!
A little peas.
Probably has more to do with the kidney malfunction than all of the other stuff. But, you know, Jay.
What'd you do?
This is my life. The highlight of my week is when the windshield wipers were on beat to a song for 4 minutes.
I swear,
I was so excited.
Oh, boy.
Four minutes.
Dude, I totally understand how cool that is. I'm one of these people who like
Are
will
you
make up.
Kidding me?
I make up songs. Like if I'm in a left turn lane and the blinkers on,
yes.
I make up songs to the rhythm of the blinkers, all the time, and I start tapping my fingers on the steering wheel to cover the spaces like the.
Oh yeah. We're about to turn left. About to turn left. Yes. We're about to turn left. Go. The light is green. If you don't go, I'm gonna be mean.
If you see Kane singing in the car, it's not to a song. It's his own.
It's to the blinkers. Yeah.
The pedal for the gas is on the right.
I cannot be the only one who does that.
Come on, turn.
I'm
we
sorry.
Don't have all night.
631. I got music in my blood, man. 631.
What'd you do?
I got at least 10,000 steps. steps in every day this week.
Wow. You did it!
Job. Me too. Well, I'm guessing. I don't have my Fitbit anymore, but I'm sure I did.
What happened to your Fitbit?
10,000 steps?
No, I'm lucky if I got 100
yeah,
steps.
Yeah, I was about to say. All you did was step home up the stairs to the couch, took a nap.
Yeah, I didn't move much this week. Things hurt.
And yet you're still... Okay, not a good sign. You're losing weight, things hurt, your kidneys are bad.
Kane's going down.
My back hurt, but not where the kidneys are.
Okay, good. That's a good sign.
Not quite news.
A little bit of everything. Remember a couple days ago when the guy from Better.com fired 900 people on Zoom?
If you're on this call, you are part of the unlucky group being laid off. Your employment here is terminated, effective immediately.
Well, now he feels bad.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, now he says, I am deeply sorry. I'm committed to learning from this situation and doing more to be the leader that you expect me to be. I failed to show the appropriate amount of respect and appreciation for the individuals who were affected and for their contributions to Better. I own the decision to do the layoffs, but in communicating it, I blundered the execution. In doing so, I embarrassed you. Yeah, an apology not accepted. If I'm one of those people.
But can I ask, who was embarrassed? Like, the only reason
the
why
company
he...
Better was pissed off.
Yeah, but the only reason why he got caught is because they filmed it. So what? They did a mass firing. At least he did. Like, he shouldn't be sorry. The fact that he's saying sorry, I don't believe him, first of all. Like, own it.
But, guys, he's not the one firing them. It's the company that's firing them.
Well, he's the CEO.
Yeah, it was his decision.
Yeah, but, like,
no, but
it's
the his
company
that's why he's saying sorry. It was his decision.
It was his decision. He's the CEO.
He did it in a bad way, so he's just saying, hey, I did it in a bad way. I'm sorry.
He's not sorry. He's done it before. He's not sorry. He's sorry because he got caught.
He said he did it before, and the last time I cried. Remember, he said that to the people on the Zoom call.
He got caught. That's why he's sorry.
No. People who were fired, though, like one guy, he says, I was promoted in June. I got a raise in October. The company also just received $750 million in funding days before the firing. But now you're crying poverty and firing all of it?
It's because of they're a lender, right? They're a mortgage lender? Better.com?
I don't know what they do.
And didn't you say something about the housing industry, Producer Jay, that's going to be going down now? Yeah, good talk.
He doesn't listen.
If I go to better.com/mortgages, yeah.
Good talk. let's move on. The Gorilla Glue Girl. God, man. Her hair problems again. You know what she's famous for, gluing her hair, right? And then she tried to dye it herself with a box from the store, and then her hair started falling out in clumps.
Yep.
So now she's famous for doing this platelet-rich plasma and stem cell therapy on her hair. That's going to cost her like $6,000, so I think she's asking for more money.
Jeez.
You messed it up yourself.
No, but you keep messing up.
I mean...
You keep screwing your hair up.
If somebody's going to say, look, you're going to be super famous with a couple of opportunities to make some money in your life, but you're going to mess your hair up twice really bad, would you do it?
No.
Really?
No. Because now she just... Because what is she going to get from this? She's not going to get anything from this.
Yeah, she's pigeonholed
herself. She looks like a fool.
Well, what do you mean? After the first... I probably didn't sell well, but after she glued her hair to itself... She got a whole hair care line.
How's that going?
I don't know. Probably not well.
Yeah, okay. Apparently, by the way, that guy from Better.com is worth $4 billion and takes a 15% cut of the company.
Whoa.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
That's a whole different spin on it there, doesn't it? And be careful if you're going to go buy Chocolate Santa this year, CVS or Duane Reade or wherever you buy your Chocolate Santas, because Cadbury is passing off old chocolate Easter bunnies as Chocolate Santas.
Cadbury, no.
That's not ho, ho, ho. Yeah, some guy was in a store. Some guy was in a store, and he picked it because, you know, it's got the tinfoil on it or whatever. Uh-huh. And he goes, he's holding it up, and he goes, that's the shape of a rabbit. They just replaced the wrapping and put a Santa on it. And he bought it for that reason and opened it up at home, and it was rabbit ears.
That's horrible.
It's Friday. That's all you get. Like it or not.
That's it.
Sorry. That's the news.
Not quite.
Kane and Corey gotta get it off the chest. No regrets.
Regrets.
They don't have Corvettes. It's best of the rest. Yeah.
Christmassy things. You can actually drink a beer from Miller Lite's new Christmas ornaments.
What?
These are awesome. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They're called beerniments. And after you cracked open and drank the beer from these bulb-shaped cans, you then hang them on the tree.
Oh, yeah. I love it.
Right?
Two in one.
That's a little redneck-y, isn't it?
You got a little pretty male thing.
pass me the beer in the mint.
Hey, man, I would love a tree with nothing but like...
Hell yeah.
I did have one year I had a tree made of Jaeger bottles.
Really?
Yeah, it was about 4 feet tall.
They sent a picture?
They sent it over to me. No, I have a picture on my Instagram of something that something like it, but that's not the tree that I actually had.
This is actually pretty a genius idea, to be honest.
The Miller Lite thing?
Yeah.
Are you looking at it?
Trashy as hell, but
maybe
yeah.
Maybe Houseguest Lisa will help you put up the tree if they have these.
Oh, she'd help me decorate if it was beer ornaments.
Yeah. I feel like if you had these, you also have the little wind chimes outside that are made out of beer cans and shaped like planes.
Everything would be made out of beer cans.
Yeah. Whoa, the picture on your Instagram, the Jaeger one, so cool.
Beernaments.com if you would like to get some of those. NFTs are apparently the big holiday gift this year. I'm on a website right now called platypunks.com.
Yeah.
PLATYPUNKS. It's a popular NFT site. The images of just nothing but platypuses.
Yeah, but like cool platypuses.
Yeah, they got sunglasses on and stuff like gold chains and whatnot.
I kind of want one.
Yeah, this dude, he's a truck driver from Dallas. He's like, I bought all my friends for Christmas NFTs. He says they'll be excited and confused. I'm on here going like, okay, first of all, I would never do that, but I was trying to find how much they cost. I couldn't find a price point on the website.
It's because you got to connect your wallet to it.
Oh, God. Oh, there's steps.
Yeah, there's steps to it, dude.
Yes.
Oh, right here. Platypunk. Art collector Platypunk. $9.19.
If you gave me an NFT for Christmas, I'll punch you square in the mouth.
But what if that NFT ended up becoming, like, a lot of money?
I'll kiss you square in the mouth.
Yeah. I'll punch you, but then I'll kiss you later on.
You got a little pretty mouth, thing.
I like the way you talk.
Another gift idea for seriously, for someone who has everything. How about the world's largest pot brownie at 850 pounds?
I saw that. That thing's huge. You saw it?
They made it up in New Bedford, Massachusetts. Took over 24 hours to bake and prepare, but look at it. There it is. There she sits.
It's massive.
And I like want it.
Everybody around it. They look like they're in lab coats and
they look smart as hell.
They look like scientists slash lunch ladies because they've got the thing on their hair.
They look like lunch ladies from MIT.
Yes.
Yeah, MIT lunch ladies.
Exactly. But it's available. It really is for sale if you would like to. Maybe they break it up and sell it in pieces. I don't know what they're going to do.
I want a piece.
Do you really? Make your own.
I have made my own.
Don't you and your mom make pot brownies all the time?
Yeah, over lockdown, my mom and I made pot brownies.
Yeah.
They were delicious.
That's quite a relationship you've got there.
Mm-hmm.
Our moms hit us with books and stuff.
Exactly. No, I wasn't even being sarcastic. I was serious. Like, that's quite a relationship you've got there.
Your mom pays a bill and makes a pot brownie.
Pays what bill, Pusher J? Come at me.
Song started.
Such anger.
He's at me all day.
I'd rather have jokes. Where are all the jokes instead of the anger? It's best of the rest.
Kane and Corey's three things we learned today.
I learned that if you would like to, you can purchase the Island Boys just for them to sing to you.
Island Boys, Palm Beach's most famous rap stars.
They're on Cameo, and they cost $186, which is $185 too much. And that's for personal messages, and if it's for business, it's $600.
I've seen businesses using them. I've seen a lot of personal people using them, too.
What business, with any respectability whatsoever, is using the Island Boys for something?
Someone that wants to be viral because of some crazy trend.
Somebody should hire them in person to come, like, do a PowerPoint.
We should hire them to do something. Tell them it's personal, get them to say something.
I don't want them anywhere near me.
No, we don't. They're not coming to us. They're just going to send us a video.
I don't want them. I want my name out their mouths.
Okay. I learned today that apparently during the holiday season, you're supposed to tip your garbage man, which is trash, if you ask me.
Yeah. And I guess back in the day, someone texted from 407 earlier, like you would stick the money just underneath the lid and like on top of the garbage or the bag that you've – like don't do that because it's going to end up on the truck.
Why would you do that? You're literally throwing away money.
Yeah.
Literally.
Well, we discussed about getting back together with our exes during the holiday season, and a poll on Instagram, our listeners says 63% did not get back with their ex. 37% sadly did, though. Huh. So
I'd like to know how that worked out.
Yeah.
Never good. Never good.
More than I imagined would.
Follow-up poll and bonus fourth thing we learned.
If you missed anything, you can get it later. Don't be a hater. Get it
on the awesome. No, 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 no.
Come on, I wanted to
No.
Add one.
No ad lib.
You know what? You don't even get to do it. Kane and Corey podcast unfiltered on the Audacy app. Goodbye, Jay.
Yay, yay, yay. 104.3 The Shark, our sincerest apologies.